Hello everyone, this is Gurveen here, and today we'll be talking about the localized entity fields in Moki. So for an introduction to localization in Moki and a brief overview of the various uses provided by the localization facade, I would recommend to go through the session 15 of the playlist. So in that session, we saw how we can provide localized labels and messages. So today we will see how we can have the entity fields that are localized so that the people will see the localized data that match their language preferences. So let us see how this is supported in Moki and how we can add the localization support through an example. So I've opened the example application. And we can see that we have some data coming from the example entity. So we'll be taking the example of this field, which is the example type. And we can see that we have few values, which is actually an enumeration. And we have few values added for the example type. So if we have a user whose language preference is other than English, so we would want that when the user logs in, he should be able to see the localized values so that he gets the look and feel of his target locale. So how this works is, for that, let us go to the IDE. So if we first have a look at the example field, which we are taking in the example entity. So we have the example type here in the example entity, which is actually an enumeration. And we have the description for some of the values of the enum IDs which are added for this field. So if we see the entity definition of enumeration entity, we have the description field, and we can see that we have the enable localization, which is set to true. So if we check this in the XSD, it tells us that if this is set to true, then any gets which are happening on this field will be looked up from the localized entity field entity. And if there is a matching record found, then the localized value will be returned, else it returns the actual record's value. So this is set to true for the fields that will have translations. Otherwise, the default setting is that it is set to false. Now, this is important as we want to add the localization support for this field in our example. So if we go to the example localization data, so what we have done is we have added a record for the localized entity field, mentioning the entity name, which is the enumeration. Then we have the field name, which is description, and we have added the records for few of the enum IDs for this example type and added the translations in the localized field, and we have set the locale to other than EN. So for the example, we have taken the French language. So if the user whose preferred language is French, if he logs in, he should be able to see these localized value instead of the original record values. So for the demo purposes, let us change the locale. And if we refresh the screen, we can see that now we are able to see the localized values for this field. So if we also open the create example dialog, and in the example type dropdown, we can see that wherever there was a matching record, then we can see the localized values, and for the other values which does not have a matching record, the original values are only coming up. So we did not have to do anything differently. It just depends on the records in the localized entity field entity. So we can also add the records from the Moki UI apart from adding in the data files. So for that, we can go to the system menu. Under data admin, like we had the localization for messages, we also have the localized entity fields. And we can see that we have a list of the records for which are added for the localized entity field. So for the existing examples, we have the geotype which is added. For a reference, this is available in the common localization data file, which is part of the Mocky framework. So we can have a reference from this file as well of how to set up the records for the localized entity fields. And we can also update any value from this UI. And it also gives us the option to add the new field where we can provide the values for entity name, the field name, then the corresponding key, the locale and the localized value. And after adding this, we should be able to view these localized values in our applications. So this is for the localized entity fields. If there is any question, please feel free to comment, or you can use the Mocky mailing list or the Stack Overflow. Thank you.